Hello and welcome to this video entitled The Intuition Behind Vector Auto-Regressions. I'm Alex Code and you can find the data, R code and slides on my GitHub page. Please see the text underneath the video for the link. So let's start by recalling the simple regression model y equals a plus bx plus e, which tries to summarize the relationship between x and y by fitting a best fit line. This is known as regression. Then we have an autoregression model where y is regressed on lagged values of itself. Y at time t is regressed on a plus b times y in the previous period at time t minus 1 plus the error term e. Auto means self. It comes from the Greek word autos. Hence, y is regressed on itself in a previous period in a model called an autoregression. And now we come to a vector autoregression model. Here, the dependent variable is a vector, and this vector is regressed on lagged values of itself. The vector zt is regressed on theta times zt minus 1 plus the error term wt. In the simple case discussed here, the vector zt consists of two variables x and y. We are interested in how x and y are related to themselves in previous periods, and this is shown by the matrix of regression coefficients theta. Wt is the corresponding vector of error terms. To make it easier to see what's going on, we can move from matrix notation to writing things out in full. On this slide, we have a vector autoregression with just one lag that we can call a VAR1 model. This slide focuses on the case of a vector autoregression with just two variables, x and y. Estimating a VAR can be as easy as estimating two OLS regressions. The first line would be this: x depends on lagged values of x and y. Then y depends on lagged values of x and y. This gives us a matrix of coefficients theta 1 1, theta 1 2, theta 2 1, and theta 2 2, shown here in green. This matrix of coefficients gives information on how lagged values of x and y help to predict future values of x and y. The W terms are the usual regression error terms that we assume are normally distributed white noise terms that are independent of each other. Hence, we can see that the vector xt, yt is regressed on itself. That's why we call it a vector autoregression. Note that there is not just one dependent variable. In this case, there are two dependent variables, x on the first row and y on the second row. Here is an example of a vector autoregression with three variables. The vector xt, yt, and zt is regressed on lagged values of itself. This is what a one lag VAR model would look like. And this is what a two lag VAR model would look like, with the second lag shown in green that is added on behind the first lag. Granger causality is a statistical hypothesis test for determining whether one time series is useful in forecasting another. Granger causality gets its name from the pioneering work by Clive Granger, published in 1969. Clive Granger was awarded the Nobel Memorial Prize in 2003 for his contributions to time series analysis. The basic idea is to test for causality or intertemporal relationships by measuring the ability to predict the future values of a time series using prior values of another time series. It is a technique designed for testing variable pairs. For example, does Y Granger cause X, or does X Granger cause Y? The basic intuition of Granger causality, therefore, is that if X helps to predict Y, then X is said to Granger cause Y. X Granger causes Y if predictions about Y based on past values of Y, as well as past values of X, are better than predictions based only on past values of Y. Lagged values of X provide statistically significant information, which can be measured in terms of F-tests or T-tests, about future values of Y. There are two underlying principles. First, the cause happens prior to its effect. And second, the cause has unique information on future values of its effect. The possible presence of Granger causality can be investigated in the following way. First, estimate yt in the following equation. Then check whether our prediction of yt improves when adding lagged values of x in the following equation. The null hypothesis that X does not Granger cause Y is supported if and only if no lagged values of X are statistically significant and collectively add explanatory power. It is important to emphasize that Granger causality does not measure true causality. We should be cautious regarding the post hoc ergo propter hoc fallacy, which comes from the Latin for after this, therefore because of this. We should be aware that one thing preceding another does not establish causal relations between the two. For example, buying a Christmas tree is often observed to occur shortly before Christmas. But of course, buying a Christmas tree before Christmas does not in itself cause Christmas to arrive. Instead, it is actually a consequence of the subsequent arrival of Christmas. So, don't trust anyone who makes causal claims on the basis of Granger causality. True causality means that if you can manipulate one variable to take a certain value, this will push another variable to take a different value. You can try this yourself. If you buy a Christmas tree in July, you can see if this will cause Christmas to take place a few weeks later. Probably it won't. With Granger causality, it is better to talk of intertemporal associations. To summarize, therefore, some of the problems with Granger causality are as follows. 1. Granger causality is not the same as causality, in the same way as soy milk is not actually milk. In the same way that a vegetarian hot dog is not an actual hot dog, and for sure it doesn't contain any dog. 2. Granger causality doesn't capture instantaneous causal relationships. Granger causality tests for relationships between variables with a lag, rather than focusing on whether variables are co-evolving at the same time. 3. This slide looks at an example of a vector auto-regression with two variables. We will practice on a fictional dataset with 4,000 firms observed over the time period 1990 to 2005. We focus on two variables, growth of sales and growth of employment. We might suspect that these variables might be related, for example, if sales growth stimulates a firm to hire new employees, or if employment growth leads to a higher output. To keep things simple, this vector auto-regression model is estimated by OLS. The results show that each variable is a statistically significant predictor of the other. For example, the coefficient on lagged employment growth in model 1 is 0.090, which suggests that higher employment growth in the previous period is associated with higher sales growth in the current period. The results also suggest that each variable Granger causes the other, because each variable is a statistically significant predictor of future values of the other variable. This example shows that vector autoregression can be a useful tool for describing the coevolution over time of a system of multiple variables. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a nice day.